67 Pall Mall Singapore will open up a cousin of 67 Pall Mall, the famous club in London. Joining us on the line now, Grant Ashton, the founder and CEO of 67 Pall Mall, and Kori Millar, the general manager of the Singapore club here. Great to have both of you with us today. Welcome to the show. Good to see you again, Grant.
Good to see you. Morning.
Hi, Kori.
Good morning. How are you? Great.
Nice. Good. Thanks. You know, Grant, it was about a year ago that I had had you on the show when you were, I believe, overseas. Now you're in Singapore. You're looking at the construction now. You're in the little room downstairs that's already built out, but upstairs it's a construction site. How are you feeling about the progress of the club?
Yeah, I'm glad to be back in. I mean, it's been a year, virtually to the day, I think it is, since I was with you last. So now I'm back in the red dots, which is wonderful after you know, the idea of 3 weeks stay at home notice was not really flying with me. So no, it's good, and we are deep in construction. I think we're just about to close up the ceilings next week, which kind of anybody in this kind of construction space would tell you as soon as the contractor says, yeah, we're closing up now. You're kind of, but that's when the big work's done, and you're into kind of the finishes and stuff like that. So, you know, we're very much on the kind of glide path to opening.
That's great. Good to see you guys. Neil Humphreys here. As we all know, there's a vibrant, popular wine scene in Singapore. Pall Mall is a very prestigious, established brand in the UK. Why did you pick Singapore? Of all the Asian places you could have picked, why Singapore?
There's nowhere else. What are you talking about? There's nowhere else in the world. What are you saying? Sacrilege. No. Yeah, I'm sure I said this about a year ago. Is, you know, we looked at where we should have our Asian base, and Singapore won. I mean, Singapore won fair and square against everywhere else. You know, we looked at where we could have gone, and it's just easy to do business here. It's a great market. You've got very inquisitive, interested, you know, wine-loving community. You've got a club culture. So, you know, very much having to, we're going to open in France in about 18 months. We just bought a property in Beaune in Burgundy. I physically have to explain the concept of a club to the French. And that's been relatively challenging in my schoolboy French to actually explain to them what a club is. Whereas, you know, here there's a long history of clubs, and in that respect, it's just a very fertile market. I mean, you know, I think I've said it before. I'm very surprised that there really aren't any international clubs here, and we're very happy to be, you know, here. And Singapore is a great place. And genuinely, I look at the changes I've seen in Singapore in the last 20 something years. The last time I was here really was in 1998, and it's changed beyond recognition. I think that it's coming of age, if you like, in terms of the international club scene. I'll be very surprised if we don't see some of the other groups here, but we're very happy to be here first. And yeah, we think it's a very, very, very good market.
Yeah, we're talking with Grant Ashton, the founder and CEO of 67 Pall Mall, and Kori Millar, the general manager at 67 Pall Mall in Singapore. Kori, you've been in Singapore over a decade. You're a PR here and taking over this club, 15,000 square feet at Shaw Center. It's going to be quite an amazing club. I think, you know, to be fair, there is some competition out there already. 1880 is around and a few others notable in Singapore, perhaps not at the international level that some of the clubs like Pall Mall are. But how do you approach this as general manager to open a club like this in a green field for 67 Pall Mall?
Yeah, I suppose, you know, the space lends itself. I mean, the space is incredible. We are very fortunate to have an incredible wine list. I think this is going to be a really sort of, you know, it's really going to take Singapore by storm. I think having, you know, we have the expertise of a master sommelier, master of wine. I think that really says quite a lot for the club. Not only that, you know, food is quite important as well, and I think Singapore being the hub of a lot of international cuisine, you know, we really sort of reached out to a lot of the members themselves. We have around 2,300 members currently, and, you know, speaking to the members regarding food, what they wanted to eat, I think is really important. And so, you know, we did a survey, we asked the questions and we got the answers, which was amazing.
And I admire your courage, I mean, to open up this club during the pandemic. It's been tough times in the last year or so for the F&B industries internationally, but particularly in Singapore. A lot of businesses have been hard hit. So what is your, I'm curious to know, Kori, what is your membership model going to look like once it opens?
So basically we have a lot of event space. We've got like five different rooms. We do have a naughty corner, which is actually sort of adapted from, we've brought that over from London. We have a space where if you're not the wine lover or you just want to sort of drink, drink other drinks, we have the whiskey area upstairs, which is called the naughty corner. We do have an amazing view over Orchard Road as well, which I think, will really sort of lend itself. We've got a beautiful garden outside. The event areas, we consist of five different rooms. These walls are adaptable, so we have different areas that, the modules can move around. We can do lots of tastings. Having, I suppose, the great exposure to a lot of wine lovers internationally, being able to bring over winemakers, having these sort of events that we will do, if we can do events eventually in 2022, cross fingers. And also just, I think the space is really sort of somewhere where people can sort of come to, really feel like it's their own. And I think, after the last sort of year, maybe even 2 years that we've been in lockdown, we're really ready to sort of give Singapore that sort of luxury of being able to come into their own space. And I think this is what the members are really excited about, is that, they do have somewhere outside of their own home that they can actually call their extension of their own home, I suppose.
Yeah, to both of you, look, we can't ignore food, right? You wine is the big draw at 67 Pall Mall, no matter where you are, you're in London or France or anywhere, but food is going to be it. You've just announced recently your chef is a Singaporean-based chef. Tell us some more about him and what you're looking at in terms of the food offerings.
Yeah, so Chef Alex Zhu, we brought him in. He's our head chef. So we did go through the questionnaire. We did sort of talk about whether we wanted to have an executive chef. We've looked at Alex as a head chef so that we can sort of adapt to the 67 Pall Mall, food offerings of what they have in London. I think we really want to follow, the brand is very important. There are a lot of signature dishes out of London, be the Scotch egg and the sausage roll and things like this that we will definitely bring in to Singapore. Also, having Alex's background was really through with Daniel Boulud. He worked his cuisine is sort of a little bit classic French. But he also did the opening with the English house, so Marco Pier White. So this has given us a really lovely balance through the menu. We are in development stage at the moment, but we're going through doing food tastings. And again, we did ask our members around the offerings and what they would like, and we were very specific and what they would, what we wanted to sort of choose for that. And I think we really got a great feeling we got some really good feedback and a great feeling for what they were looking at. Of course, vegetarian, vegan is a big question or a big ask. I think a lot of people are moving into very sort of light cuisine. We're doing lots of salads, very fresh, a very fresh food and really product driven. I'm actually from New Zealand, so produce is a very big thing and a very important thing to me, as well as it is to chef. So, yeah.
Well, never mind all that, Kori. You've made me very happy because I believe you said Pall Mall, which is how I said it as a kid. When it was on the Monopoly board, it was the prestigious one next to Mayfair. It was always Pall Mall. And then as I got older, posh people started calling it Pall Mall. So at some point, I had to change. I mean, if one of you two could clarify which one it is, but I say Pall Mall.
I'm with you. I'm working on Corey's accent. Don't worry.
Well, Pall Mall or Pall Mall, they both stand. And but what is interesting about I'm staying with Pall Mall now is that I admire the fact, Grant, as I said earlier, that you are expanding into Singapore. You mentioned France just now. Yeah. You seem to have a very aggressive expansion outlook at what has been a tough time for everybody. Mm-hmm. Firstly, why? And what are your long-term plans?
I mean, my view is certainly in club, being a club operator, if you're not going forward, you're going backwards. I mean, people very much, you know, we are driving through to probably 6 or 7 clubs being open in the next 5 years. So, you know, it's not really a secret that we have a property in Verbier, which we're going to open in a few weeks, literally 3 weeks' time, which we just have purchased. We're in the process of getting that open. Obviously, Singapore is in 3 months. We have Bone, which we've purchased. We're in negotiations on a property in Bordeaux in France. And then, you know, we're very much looking, you know, Singapore, as I said earlier, is our base, our kind of regional hub of what we want to try and do in Asia. So we're certainly looking at Shanghai. I think that in the fullness of time, you know, I'm going to base myself over here. And, you know, we'll look at Melbourne, we'll look at Sydney, we'll look at Tokyo. So these are very much where we want to go. The other thing is, you know, we have, during lockdown, since I last spoke to you, Glenn, we've launched a TV channel. So we've been doing lots of online tastings, a bit like this, where we've been sending out wine to our members in London, because clearly being locked down and not being able to get people into the club, you know, we sent out wine all over Europe and provided about 1,000 wine tastings like this using Zoom. We've turned that into a 24-hour TV channel, which, you know, is part of the expansion plan. So I mean, very much we are looking at, you know, now being a mini group, you know, so having 6-7 places open, you know, with a view that we certainly have got more things to do in Europe, but the, you know, I'll say it quietly, it's the ability to look for good deals on office space or interesting spaces. You know, we found that there's a very willing market in terms of property owners and people wanting us to come and do a 6-7 Pall Mall in their town. And let's face it, clubs are just footprint. They are space. And the more space you have, the more members you can have. And very much in a aggressive market where you've got lots of people chasing the same properties, you end up with a very, it's just tough economics. Whereas right now, you know, we've been taking further space in London and very much looking at quite good deals, you know, that we're seeing around the world. Because at the end of the day, the world has changed. And I think that, you know, you can either sit and retrench, pull your horns in and do nothing, which I just can't do. Or you take the opportunity and say, right, these are, you know, generational opportunities to expand the group, you know, buying property, taking freehold property or leasehold, long lease property, and taking the group forward at a time when others aren't. Frankly.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll definitely see how it all goes. We're looking forward to the opening in mid-February next year of 67 Pall Mall in the in the Orchard Road area in Shaw Center up at the penthouse. Grant Ashton, the founder, and Kori Millar, general manager, thanks so much for being with us today on the show. Appreciate it. Looking forward to seeing you in the club.
Grant, thank you very much. Lovely to meet you.
Thank you.